Namaste guys. So my sister and I and my niece have decided to go to Singapore for a few days, and since it's going to be an all girls trip and we're going to be on our own, it's going to be a bit of an adventure. So obviously I decided to make a little travel journal to record all our fun adventures and add pictures of all the places that we go see and brochures, basically collect all the memorabilia and compile it into one little book like I did for my Thailand trip. The construct of this album is going to be pretty much the same. It's going to be a junk journal style smash book album, and it's going to have the same black cardstock base. But I'm not going to make it as grungy or vintagey looking as I did with my Thailand journal, because it's going to be very, like I said, it's going to be an all girls trip, so I want the colors to be really girly and fun and bright. So I'm still going to be inking the edges. I haven't decided what shade yet, but I'm going to very quickly show you the supplies that I'm going to be using to make my album. So let me just start with the first, the base of my book. The base of my book, I'm going to be using this black A4 sized cardstock, and this is from Fabriano El Air. It's a 220 GSM A4 sized pack, and you get them in packs of six. And I just love this cardstock for my minis because it's got a very good texture to it. It's very nice and easy to write on with your white gel pen, which is one of my favorite accessories to take along. As well as once you add pattern paper to these, it looks really nice. It's got this nice grain on one side and the other side is pretty smooth. So this is usually my right side up, the grain side. So this is what I'm going to be using to make my scrapbook, the base of my album with. And apart from that, I have some artist paper in two different sizes and from two different companies. So what I'm going to be using these for is I'm probably going to be using them to make tags to add into my journal, because I want to have something to sketch on. Let me just show you this one. This is in 5 and 7, and it is 300 GSM, very beautiful paper, look at that. And I'm thinking it'll be amazing to, you know, do a little bit of sketching on and journaling on. And I haven't decided, I might just leave them plain, or I just might add pattern paper on one side and then maybe add a photo and use one side to journal on. So I haven't decided which one I'm going to be using. They're pretty much the same. This one is 5 by 7 and this one is 5.5 by 7. So I'm going to be showing you the size of my journal, and then according to that I'm going to decide which one I'll be putting in. And the rest of it is pretty simple. I'm going to use the pattern paper that I've decided. It's by Jeff. I didn't know Jeff made pattern papers, because up till now I'd only seen punches from them and a couple of little odd crafting accessories. I have a bone folder from them, I think. So I didn't know they made pattern papers. And this one is known as Sunny Day, and it has 12 different prints and 24 sheets, two of each. So I'm going to be using half of this, I believe, because I'll show you how. Basically, the construct of my album is again going to be a Coptic binding, and I'm going to have, till now what I've decided is I'm going to have 5 signatures going in. I might add another one depending on the thickness of my album and, you know, the requirement of the construction. So how I basically plan my travel journal is I prefer to have one signature per day. So that gives me a lot of room to journal and add photos in and brochures, and it keeps it very organized. So I know which day I'm on and where do I need to add my add the little things and bits and bobs that I collect, my bills, so I can immediately go to that signature and add it. And it keeps it really easy for me to scrapbook on the go. So that's how I decided to yank out 12 sheets from my stack, and I'm going to use 2 sheets each and coordinate them, and per signature I'm going to use 2 sheets, and it's a 12 by 12 paper pack, and my album is going to be a little small this time. I'm not going to make a big chunky one like I did with my Thailand journal. And some little things that I thought I might show you right here. I don't know, I'm going to be using a lot of stuff obviously, but and I don't have them here right now with me, but I'll show you when I do a flip through of my finished journal. So I just bought this. This is like a little mini haul. I bought this just yesterday and I really liked it, and I think I don't know what company this is called. Forever in Time. It's a Forever in Time scrapbook collection sticker trends. It was really expensive. It is really expensive. It's made in Canada. I don't know if you can see that. And it's got this very grungy, vintagey looking images on here. And I thought this would be really good for my cover. So I'm going to be using all of this to design the cover, or and maybe some of them inside the album, or through the album. It has this really cute cute little circle tags. They all say traveler. So and they've got butterflies in it, and that's what I'm going to use to tie in all of my pages. I'm going to be using a lot of butterfly images and stickers and cutouts, die cuts through my album to tie in the pages. So that's that for the cover. And I found this yesterday at my local stationery store, and I really liked this. It was pretty cheap compared to this one. This one was for $200 and this one was for $165, and look at the amount of things I got in it. So it is basically a little mini album. It says mini book kit, and I have no idea who makes these. It's made in China, Shanghai, China, it says. So the things that in this kit are, there's a chipboard book, 2 pages, die-cut shapes, die-cut chipbook sheets, die-cut paper sheets, and bag of embellishments. So this is the bag of embellishments. Got a little bit of tiny ribbons, and I see a little rickrack ribbon there, and some buttons, and some bling. So it's too pink and doesn't match with the color scheme of my book. I might not be using that, but I really like the die cuts in here. It's got some really cute butterflies. And then let me just start at the beginning. And these are the 2 sheets from the book. I have it upside down, and this one is so nice. It's got some writings on it. It's double-sided. So I thought this would be amazing, really nice. I bought 2 of these. So I'm not going to be creating a book with this. I may create a book and add it as is in my album, but it's going to be too big because I'm keeping my journal a little thin this time. I want it to fit in my bag, and I don't want it to be really chunky and heavy. So I'm going to use really flat embellishments this time. I might just cut these out and use them as tags through my album. So I don't know. Let's see where we go from there. And these are the stickers that come with this little kit, and these are the little embellishments they've given with the book. So it's supposed to go right here. They've already designed your layout, so I'm not going to be using them the way I have no idea how this goes. This probably goes somewhere here or here, just basically to embellish the pages, act as pattern paper, I guess. So I've got some of that and 3 sticker sheets. So that's a lot for $165. compared to this one, which was super expensive. I hadn't seen the price at the time I was picking it up, so oops. So that's that. And the other thing that I decided I would use was the Mariposa little mat stack from Mariposa. It's a DCWB, really old paper pack, and I have it in the 6.5 and 4.5 size, and I really love this stack. I've already used some of it, but I thought it would be it would really go with the colors from this paper pack. Just look at that. And I thought that these would be amazing to create my inserts for my book, because I don't like cutting up my pages too much. I like to keep them straight, my lines straight and simple, and I just love to use my pattern paper as is. So this would be nice. It has, obviously it's Mariposa, so it's got all the butterflies in it, and that keeps it in tune with my theme. And the last thing that I'm going to show you is the other thing that I bought yesterday was this huge file folder, and this is made of some really heavy duty chipboard, and this is what I'm going to be using to make the cover of my book. So I'm going to, it's already scored at the binding, so I'm going to be making a couple of more scores probably, or I'm just going to cut it up and see how it fits into my album. But it has a lot of chipboard that I can get out of it, and I really loved this thing, and it was super 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 cheap. So I'm going to be using that as my cover. And the last thing is I'm going to be using some acetate sheets. This is regular acetate sheet that you get at any office supply store. So because one of my pages in my journal for each of the signature is an acetate page. So I'll show you that when I go, when I'm doing the tutorial for my signatures. So this is just regular A4 sized OHP film that you call here. So that's it. That's all the supplies that I'm going to be using. Oh, sorry about that. That was not the last. I'm going to be showing you a couple of extra 12 by 12 sheets that I pulled out of my stash that I thought would go with the theme of my book and the papers that I'm using, because I don't know if I'm going to be using all of these, but I'm just going to show you because I might use them. So I'm going to be using this, obviously. I really love this paper, and I'm just really running out. It's from Francis and Myers, and I use this in my Thailand journal as well. I'm sorry, I don't know where I bought these, but I did buy them loose. I didn't buy them from a paper pack or something, so that's why I don't know what collection they're from. But I really love this ledger, these checkered looks on the thing. It's really nice for journaling because I used this in my Thailand journal, and it was really easy to write on these. And these are plain on the other side, so I can glue down my photos and have drawings and sketches on this. So I'm going to be using some of that. And this is again, this is from a DCWB stack of papers, and it's a collection of I just pulled it out because I thought I might just use it for one of the covers, inside covers probably. So I have that. And this again is, this is an EcoPark paper. It's the Springtime collection. It's double-sided. I don't know, I might be using them for tags, or maybe create some library pockets out of these. So I pulled that out. And then I bought some, I had a little scrapbook pack a while ago, and I use all of the sheets from that, but I didn't use the transparency. But I probably might be using this transparency here. So this is a transparency. Let me just grab. So this is what it looks like. So I might use this, cut it up and use this as one of my pages. So I might use this one. I don't know what collection that was from. And then I have some individual sheets. This is from, I think this is from, I don't know which collection this is from. Again, these are loose sheets that I bought. I think this is from one of the DCWB stacks, and I bought them online. I bought it for the images. So I may just cut these out and use them to embellish my pages. So I'll just put the link of the store I bought these from. So okay, this one at least has its tag. It's a recollections paper, and it's got these really lovely frames. So I might be using some of these frames, cut them out and add them to embellish the pages. And again, this one is a paper from Via Memory Creepers, Grandma's Kitchen. And I really love the lines on this, and this is double sided. So I might just use this one as well. So that's the extra sheet of papers that I might be using.